read in Acts chapter 1. Acts chapter 1. The former treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after that he had through the Holy Spirit, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. To him also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which, saith he, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. And here we are in the land of Oz, and we're still testifying of the saving grace of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. Then returned they unto Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem a Sabbath day's journey. And when they were come in, they went up into an upper room, where abode Peter and James and John and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon Zelotes, and Judas the brother of James. These all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the women, and Mary the mother of Jesus, and with his brethren. And in those days Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples and said, The number of names together were about 120. Men and brethren, this scripture must needs have been fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit by the mouth of David spake before concerning Judas, which was guide to them that took Jesus. In other words, speaking of Judas Iscariot, the betrayer. For he was numbered with us and had obtained part of this ministry. Now this man purchased a field with the reward of iniquity, and falling headlong, he burst asunder in the midst, and all his bowels gushed out. And it was known unto all the dwellers at Jerusalem, insomuch as that field is called in their proper tongue a seldomer, that is to say, the field of blood. But it is written in the book of Psalms, Let his habitation be desolate, and let no man dwell therein, and his bishopric let another take. Wherefore, of these men which have accompanied with us all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John, unto that same day that he was taken up from us, must one be ordained to be a witness with us of his resurrection. And they appointed two, Joseph called Barsabas, who was surnamed Justus, and Matthias. And they prayed and said, Thou Lord, which knowest the hearts of all men, show whether of these two thou hast chosen, that he may take part of this ministry and apostleship, from which Judas by transgression fell, that he might go to his own place. And they gave forth their lots, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was numbered with the 11 apostles. See, Judas was never ever saved, my friend. He was a fake apostle. He was a fake disciple, a fake Christian. I wonder, are you a fake Christian? Have you really believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God and become a child of God through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ alone? Or you've climbed up some other way, as it were, and you're hoping to enter into heaven by doing good works. You know, being a good person, whatever. It'll never ever get us to heaven, my friend. We've got to come God's way. And God's way is repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. Repentance being a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner and then place your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And then as a result of that faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior, your soul be saved, my friend. You see, it's not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his grace and mercy, he has saved us. And so you and I have to realize that we are sinners in the sight of the Lord when we're born into this world. We need to become saints. We need to be born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If we do not believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll be in hell at the moment of death, my friend. What will you do then with Jesus, which is called the Christ? Will he be your Savior? Or will he have to be your judge? Moving on now to Acts chapter 2. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now this was a miraculous gift that was given unto these believers here, these early believers. They were able to speak in another language, having never learned it. It means a language or a dialect. It's an understandable language in that particular, for that particular nationality. And they were dwelling at Jerusalem, Jews, devout men out of every nation under heaven. Now, when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, Behold, are not all these which speak Galileans? And how hear we every man in our own tongue, wherein we were born? Parthians and Medes and Elamites and the dwellers in Mesopotamia and in Judea and Cappadocia and Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt and in the parts of Libya about Cyrene, and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of God. In other words, in our language or our dialect, the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and were in doubt, saying one to another, What meaneth this? Others mocking said, These men are full of new wine. In other words, these fellows are drunk. But Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, Ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. For these are not drunken, as ye suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. You prepare to do that, my friend, right now. Call upon the name of the Lord and your soul be saved, my friend. This is what God wants for each and every one of us. Whether we're a man, woman, boy or girl, He wants us to be in heaven. We cannot be there apart from faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved us enough to die upon the cross. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and He was buried. But praise God, the third day He rose again according to the scriptures. When is your soul saved? As you listen to this message this morning, are you ready to meet God? Should the Lord Jesus Christ happen to return right now, would you be caught up to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord? Or will you be left behind to go through the seven-year tribulation period upon the earth? The last 3.5 years is called the Great Tribulation. There's no need to be left behind in any of those 7 years, my friend. You can be saved by the grace of God through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. What you need to do is come in repentance toward God. That is, a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner. And then place your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know, him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken, and by wicked hands have crucified and slain, whom God hath raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holden of it. For David speaketh concerning him, I foresaw the Lord always before my face, for he is on my right hand, that I should not be moved. Therefore did my heart rejoice, and my tongue was glad. Moreover, also my flesh shall rest in hope, because thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither wilt thou suffer thine Holy One to see corruption. Thou hast made known to me the ways of life. Thou shalt make me full of joy with thy countenance. Men and brethren, let me freely speak unto you of the patriarch David, that he is both dead and buried, and his sepulchre is with us unto this day. Therefore, being a prophet, and knowing that God had sworn with an oath to him, that of the fruit of his loins, according to the flesh, he would raise up Christ to sit on his throne, he, seeing this before, spake of the resurrection of Christ, that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh did see corruption. This Jesus hath God raised up, whereof we all are witnesses. Yes, praise God, he's risen the third day according to the scriptures. He's no longer in the tomb, my friend. He's alive. The Lord Jesus Christ is alive forevermore. He's the eternal Son of the living God, my friend. And he was made sin for us, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. If you come in repentance toward God, acknowledging your sinful condition before the Lord, and then reaching out the hand of faith to the Lord Jesus Christ, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. I wonder, is your soul saved? As you drive past this morning, are you ready to meet God? Are you on your way to heaven? Or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? There's no need for that, my friend. You can get on the narrow road that leads to heaven. through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Be it, do it now before it's forever and eternally too late. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he hath shed forth this which ye now see and hear. For David is not ascended into the heavens, but he saith himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou on my right hand until I make thy foes thy footstool. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made that same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent, and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Now we must understand that baptism does not save anyone, my friend. Baptism is the answer of a good conscience toward God, and so that those who have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ and become children of God through faith alone in Christ have a good conscience toward God, and then they go ahead and get baptized. That's full immersion in water. That is believer's baptism, my friend. It's got nothing to do with getting to heaven. It's got everything to do with being obedient to our newfound Savior. The moment you get saved, you need to go out and get baptized, my friend. That is the Lord's desire for all of his people, that they would be baptized in obedience to the command of the Lord to be baptized. And it's just showing her the fact that you have died with Christ, was buried with Christ, and you've risen to walk in newness of life with Christ. It's an outward expression of the thing that's already taken place in our souls as believers in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It's just the outward show of that, the outward testimony concerning it. I wonder, if you're a believer, have you been baptized? You need to be baptized in obedience to the Lord Jesus Christ. As I said, it's got nothing to do with getting to heaven. It's just the first step of obedience for the child of God. For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Then they that gladly received his word were baptized. And the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. And they continued steadfastly in the apostle doctrine, and in fellowship, and in breaking of bread, and in prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles, and all that believed were together, and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favour with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. What of this morning, are you saved? Are you on your way to heaven? Are you going to heaven, or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? God does not want you to go to hell, my friend. And that's why I'm here this morning preaching unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, that you would be saved, that you would come to know the Lord Jesus as your Savior. Without him, we're dead in our trespasses and in our sins, heading down to hell, because our sins have not been forgiven. If that's your case this morning. But God wants you to be saved this morning. God wants you to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. And you can come to know him by repentance toward God, as I keep on saying, change your mind, agree with God that you are a sinner, and then place your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and then your soul will be saved. You know, the Word of God says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That is the way of salvation. It's through the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ that He shed for us freely upon the cross of Calvary. You see, it cost God everything to send His Son from heaven. It wasn't an easy thing for the Father to spare His Son to come down to this sin-cursed earth and die upon the cross for you and for me, and be crucified for the likes of you and I, sinful creatures that we are. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Are you a saint? Have you been born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ? Just moving on now to Acts chapter 3. Acts chapter 3, now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. In other words, to beg for money. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God, and they knew that it was he which sat for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. And as the lame man was with, which was healed, held Peter and John, all the people ran together unto them in the porch that is called Solomon's, greatly wondering. When Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this, or why look ye so earnestly on us, as though by our own power or holiness we had made this man to walk? The God of Abraham, and of Isaac, and of Jacob, the God of our fathers, hath glorified his Son Jesus, whom ye delivered up and denied him in the presence of Pilate, when he was determined to let him go. But ye denied the Holy One and the Just, and desired a murderer to be granted unto you, that was Barabbas, and killed the Prince of Life, whom God hath raised from the dead, whereof we are witnesses. And his name, through faith in his name, hath made this man strong, whom ye see and know. Yea, the faith which is by him hath given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. And now, brethren, I wot that through ignorance ye did it. In other words, I know that through ignorance ye did it, as did also your rulers. Those things which God before had showed by the mouth of all his prophets, that Christ should suffer, he has so fulfilled. Repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord, and he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you, whom the heaven must receive until the times of restitution of all things, which God has spoken by the mouth of all his holy prophets since the world began. For Moses truly said unto their fathers, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you of your brethren like unto me. Him shall ye hear in all things whatsoever he shall say unto you. And it shall come to pass that every soul which will not hear that prophet shall be destroyed from among the people, yea, and all the prophets from Samuel, and those that follow after, as many as have spoken, have likewise foretold of these days. Ye are the children of the prophets, and of the covenant which God made with our fathers, saying unto Abraham, and in thy seed shall all the kindreds of the earth be blessed. Unto you first, God, having raised up his Son Jesus, sent him to bless you, in turning away every one of you from his iniquities. That's what the Lord wants to do for you this morning, my friend. He wants to bless you with everlasting life and turn you away from your iniquities. We might have received forgiveness for our sins through faith in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. I wonder, is your soul saved? Are you on your way to heaven? Are you stood on the broad road which leads down to hell and destruction? Acts chapter 4. And as they spake unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them, being grieved, but they taught the people and preached through Jesus the resurrection from the dead. And they laid their hands on them and put them in hold unto the next day, for it was now eventide. Howbeit many of them which heard the word believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000. And it came to pass on the morrow that their rulers and elders and scribes and Annas the high priest and Caiaphas and John and Alexander and as many as were of the kindred of the high priest were gathered together at Jerusalem. And when they had set them in the midst, they asked, by what power or by what name have you done this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said unto them, ye rulers of the people and elders of Israel, if we this day be examined of the good deed done to the impotent man, by what means he is made whole, be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him, doth this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Did you hear that? There's no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. The name of Jesus Christ, he is the one. He is the only Saviour for us poor sinners when we're born into this world. We need to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ as our Saviour. Without him, we're dead in our trespasses and in sins, heading down to hell because those sins have not been forgiven. But I'm here to tell you that your sins can be forgiven. And the only way is through the death, burial, and resurrection, and the precious blood that was shed upon the cross of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, and our right response to that. You see, he came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, that is Jesus Christ, to them, gave him power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Have you believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God? Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled, and they took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus. And beholding the man which was healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred among themselves, saying, what shall we do to these men? For that indeed a notable miracle hath been done by them is manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem. And we cannot deny it. But that it spread no further among the people, let us frankly threaten them that they speak henceforth to no man in this name. And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of Jesus. Peter and John answered and said unto them, whether it be right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye. We cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard. So when they had further threatened them, let them go. They let them go, finding nothing how they might punish them, because of the people, for all men glorified God for that which was done. For the man was above 40 years old, on whom this miracle of healing was showed. And being let go, they went to their own company and reported all that the chief priests and elders had said unto them. And when they heard that, they lifted up their voice to God with one accord and said, Lord, thou art God, which has made heaven and earth and the sea and all that in them is, who by the mouth of thy servant David has said, why did the heathen rage and the people imagine vain things? The kings of the earth stood up, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For of a truth, against thy holy child Jesus, whom thou hast anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, were gathered together, for to do whatsoever thy hand and thy counsel determined before to be done. And now, Lord, behold their threatenings, and grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word, stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus. When they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spake the word of God with boldness. The multitude of them that believed were of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any of them that aught of the things which he possessed were his own, but they had all things common. And with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Neither was there any among them that lacked, for as many as were possessors of land or houses sold them, and brought the prices of the things that were sold, and laid them down at the apostles' feet, and distribution was made unto every man according as he had need. And Joseph, who by the apostles was surnamed Barnabas, which is being interpreted the son of Consolation, a Levite, and of the country of Cyprus, having land, sold it, and brought the money and laid it at the apostles' feet. Well, we'll leave the reading there, but the main issue is our sin. You know, our sins are taking us down to that terrible place called hell. And God does not want you to go down to hell, where he will judge you. The moment you die, my friend, you will be in hell without Christ. But I'm here to tell you that your soul needs to be saved. And God wants you to be in heaven, my friend, and that's why I'm here. Preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ unto you, that you would pass from death unto life, that you would pass from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of the Son of God's love. The Lord Jesus Christ alone is the Saviour. There is no other Saviour for us poor sinners. As we're born in this world as sinners, we need to become children of God. And no, we're not all children of God. Some people think that we're all children of God. We're not. Until we be born again into God's family, we are not, I repeat, we are not God's children. We've got to be born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. If you will come in repentance toward God this morning, change your mind, agree with God that you are a sinner, and then believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and then your soul will be saved. It doesn't rely upon anything that we can do. It's the finished work of Jesus Christ upon the cross of Calvary. Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and he was buried, and he rose again the third day according through the scriptures. Your eternal destiny depends on what you do with the Lord Jesus Christ. In whom we have redemption, through his blood even, the forgiveness of sins. What will it be for you, heaven or hell? Salvation or damnation? Will he be your savior or will he have to be your judge? Will you have peace with God or will you remain being an enemy of God by your wicked works and your mind and your sinful behavior? We actually are the enemies of God before we become the friends of God through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Make a wise choice, my friend. Get right with God. As a result of repentance toward God, as I've said, change your mind, agree with God that you are a sinner, and then place your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do it now before it's forever and eternally too late. If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening. I'm going to read from Acts chapter 5. But a certain man named Ananias with Sapphira, his wife, sold a possession and kept back part of the price, his wife also being privy to it, and brought a certain part and laid it at the apostles' feet. But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled thine heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and to keep back part of the price of the land? Whilst it remained, was it not thine own? And after it was sold, was it not in thine own power? Why hast thou conceived this thing in thine heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God. Again proving that the Holy Spirit, he also, is God. Along with the Father and the Son, they are all God. There are three that make up the Godhead, my friend. There's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And Ananias, hearing these words, fell down and gave up the spirit. And great fear came on all them that heard these things. And the young men arose, wound him up, and carried him out, and buried him. And it was about the space of 3 hours after, when his wife, not knowing what was done, came in. And Peter answered unto her, tell me whether ye sold the land for so much. And she said, yea, for so much. Then Peter said unto her, how is it that ye have agreed together to tempt the Spirit of the Lord? Behold, the feet of them which have buried thy husband are at the door, and shall carry thee out. Then fell she down straightway at his feet, and yielded up the spirit. And the young men came in and found her dead, and carrying her forth, buried her by her husband. And great fear fell upon all the church, and upon as many as heard these things. By the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, and they were with all. All with one accord in Solomon's porch. And of the rest durst no man join himself unto them, but the people magnified them. In other words, no man dared to join themselves unto them, but everyone magnified the name of the Lord.
Sorry about this, but I've got to put a plastic bag over the camera because it's just starting to rain. So hopefully you can still hear and see something.
Acts chapter 5. And the young men arose. arrows, wound him up and carried him out and buried him. And it was about the space of 3 hours after, when his wife, not knowing what was done, came in. Peter answered unto her, "Tell me whether ye sold the land for so much." She said, "Yea, for so much." Then Peter said unto her, "How is it that ye have agreed together to tempt the Spirit of the Lord? Behold, the feet of them which have buried thy husband are at the door, and shall carry thee out." Then fell she down straightway at his feet, and yielded up the spirit. And the young man came in, and found her dead, and carrying her forth, buried her by her husband. And great fear came upon all the church, and upon as many as heard these things. And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, and they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch, and of the rest durst no man join himself to them. In other words, no one dared to join themselves unto them, but the people magnified them. And believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes both of men and women, insomuch as that they brought forth the sick into the streets, and laid them on beds and couches, that at the least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. There came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks, and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed every one. In other words, those that were demon-possessed as well. And they were healed every one. Then the high priest rose up, and all they that were with him, which is the sect of the Sadducees, and were filled with indignation, and laid their hands on the apostles, and put them in the common prison. But the angel of the Lord by night opened the prison doors, and brought them forth, and said, "Go stand and speak in the temple to the people all the words of this life." And when they heard that, they entered into the temple early in the morning, and taught. But the high priest came, and they that were with him, and called the council together, and all the senate of the children of Israel, and sent to the prison to have them brought. But when the officers came and found them not in the prison, they returned and told, saying, "The prison truly found we shut with all safety, and the keepers standing without before the doors. But when we had opened, we found no man within." Now when the high priest and the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this would grow. Then came one and told them, saying, "Behold, the man whom ye put in prison is standing in the temple, and teaching the people." Then went the captain with the officers, and brought them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should have been stoned. When they had brought them, they set them before the council, and the high priest asked them, saying, "Did not we straitly command you that ye should not teach in this name? And behold, ye have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine, and intend to bring this man's blood upon us." Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, "We ought to obey God rather than men. The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Him God hath exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a saviour, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. He's the only way to heaven, my friend, the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." And we are witnesses, his witnesses, of these things. And so is also the Holy Spirit, whom God hath given to them that obey him. When they heard that, they were cut to the heart, and took counsel to slay them. Then stood there up one in the councillor Pharisee named Gamaliel, a doctor of the law, had in reputation among all the people, and commanded to put the apostles forth a little space, and said unto them, Ye men of Israel, take heed to yourselves what ye intend to do as touching these men. For before these days rose up Thaddeus, boasting himself to be somebody, to whom a number of men, about 400, joined themselves, who was slain, and all as many as obeyed him were scattered and brought to naught. After this man rose up Judas of Galilee in the days of the taxing, and drew away much people after him. He also perished in all, even as many as obeyed him were dispersed. And now I say unto you, refrain from these men, and let them alone, for if this counsel or this word be of men, it will come to naught. But if it be of God, ye cannot overthrow it, lest haply ye be found even to fight against God. And to him they agreed, and when they had called the apostles and beaten them, they commanded that they should not speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. They departed from the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. And daily in the temple and in every house they ceased not to teach and preach Jesus Christ. And I hope that that's me, that will be me, or that is me, that I will not cease to teach and to preach Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 6, and in those days was the number of the disciples, when the number of the disciples was multiplied, there rose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews, because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration. Then the 12 called the multitude of the disciples unto them, and said, It is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. In other words, the preaching of the gospel is of more importance than serving tables. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you seven men of honest repute. Seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. But we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word, that is, preaching. To prayer and preaching. And the saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit, and Philip, and Prochorus and Nicanor, and Timon, and Parmenas, and Nicholas, the proselyte of Antioch, whom they set before the apostles, and when they had prayed, they laid their hands on them, and the word of God increased, and the number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient to the faith. And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Then there arose certain of the synagogue, which is called the synagogue of the Libertines and Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and of them of Cilicia and of Asia, disputing with Stephen. And they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spake. Then they support men which said, we have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes and came upon him and caught him and brought him to the council and set up false witnesses which said, this man ceaseth not to speak blasphemous words against this holy place and the law. We have heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth shall destroy this place and shall change the customs which which Moses delivered us. And all that sat in the council, looking steadfastly on him, saw his face as it had been the face of an angel. Acts chapter 7. Then said the high priest, are these things so? And he said, men, brethren, and fathers, hearken. The God of glory appeared unto our father Abraham when he was in Mesopotamia before he dwelt in Charan. And said unto him, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred, and come into the land which I shall show thee. Then came he out of the land of the Chaldeans and dwelt in Charan. And from thence, or from there, when his father was dead, he removed him into this land, wherein ye now dwell. And he gave him none inheritance in it, no, not so much as to set his foot on. Yet he promised that he would give it to him for a possession, and to his seed after him, when as yet he had no child. And God spake on this wise, or in this way, that his seed should sojourn in a strange land, and that they should bring them into bondage, and entreat them evil 400 years. And the nation to whom they shall be in bondage will I judge, said God. And after that shall they come forth and serve me in this place. And he gave him the covenant of circumcision. And so Abraham begat Isaac and circumcised him the eighth day. And Isaac begat Jacob, and Jacob begat the 12 patriarchs. And the patriarchs, moved with envy, sold Joseph into Egypt, but God was with him, and delivered him out of all his afflictions, and gave him favour and wisdom in the sight of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And he made him governor over Egypt and all his house. Now there came a dearth over all the land of Egypt and Chanaan, and great affliction, and our fathers found no sustenance. But when Jacob heard that there was corn in Egypt, he sent our fathers first. And at the second time Joseph was made known to his brethren, and Joseph's kindred was made known unto Pharaoh. Then sent Joseph and called his father Jacob to him, and all his kindred, 75 souls, in other words, 75 souls. So Jacob went down to Egypt, and died he and our fathers, and were carried over into Sychem, and laid in the sepulchre that Abraham bought for a sum of money of the sons of Emor, the father of Sychem. And when the time of the promise drew near, which God has sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied in Egypt, till another king arose which knew not Joseph. The same dealt subtly with our kindred, and evil entreated our fathers, so that they cast out their young children to the end they might not live. In which time Moses was born, and was exceeding fair, and nourished up in his father's house 3 months. And when he was cast out, Pharaoh's daughter took him up, and nourished him for her own son. And Moses was learned in all the wisdom of the Egyptians, and was mighty in words and in deeds. And when he was full 40 years old, it came into his heart to visit his brethren, the children of Israel. And seeing one of them suffer wrong, he defended him, and avenged him that was oppressed, and smote the Egyptian, We supposed his brethren would have understood how that God by his hand would deliver them, but they understood not. And the next day he showed himself unto them as they strove, and would have set them at one again, saying, Sirs, ye be brethren, why do ye wrong one to another? But he that did his neighbour wrong thrust him away, saying, Who made thee a ruler and a judge over us? Wilt thou kill me as thou didst the Egyptian yesterday? Then fled Moses at this saying, and was a stranger in the land of Madian, where he begat two sons. And when 40 years were expired, there appeared to him in the wilderness of Mount Sinai as an angel of the Lord in a flame of fire in a bush. When Moses saw it, he wondered at the sight, and as he drew near to behold it, the voice of the Lord came unto him, saying, I am the God of thy fathers, the God of Abraham, and the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Then Moses trembled, and durst not behold. He dared not behold, in other words. Then said the Lord to him, Put off thy shoes from thy feet, for the place where thou standest is holy ground. I have seen the affliction of my people which is in Egypt, and I have heard their groaning, and am come down to deliver them. And now come, I will send thee into Egypt. This Moses, whom they refused, saying, Who made thee a ruler and a judge?